If you've ever felt frustrated by vitamin C serums, either because they irritate your skin or because you're unsure if they actually work, you're not alone in that confusion. The skincare world keeps telling us that L-ascorbic acid is the gold standard, but what if your skin can't tolerate it? Or what if the solution everyone recommends just isn't the right for you? That's exactly where Tetrahexyldecyl Ascorbate steps in. It's the form of vitamin C used inside the Sunday Riley C.E.O. serum, and some people swear it is just as effective, but much gentler. I've been testing it to see whether this luxury serum lives up to the claims and whether it really is a better option for those of us with sensitive or maturing skin. In this video, I'll break down exactly how this vitamin C derivative works, what the science says, and most importantly, if it is worth your money. Welcome back to my channel. I'm Dr. Anne, a medical doctor here to teach you how to best take care of your skin and general well-being. Sunday Riley claims it helps with dullness, hyperpigmentation, and restores the skin's bounciness, all of which are common claims for vitamin C. Now, there are watery serums and creamier ones, and this one belongs into the latter category. It feels like a lotion when applied. It's white, no golden specks in here, that is strictly limited to the bottle, and has a beautiful subtle citrusy scent. According to the website, you should use 2 pumps morning and night for your face, which I think is a lot. Due to the great spreadability, 1 pump is enough to cover my face and take it down to my neck. Maybe I just have a small head, but I think 2 pumps just for the face would be too much. And while you can use vitamin C twice a day, I usually stick to once a day in the mornings. The reasoning behind using it twice a day is that during the day it will be used up to combat free radicals, while at night it could work on brightening hyperpigmentation and increasing collagen synthesis. There is surely truth to that, but I have other things in my evening routine and don't want to use a gazillion steps, and I trust that there will be something left for other things even when applied in the mornings. Given that it doesn't use L-ascorbic acid, but tetrahexyldecyl ascorbate, using it twice a day and even alongside other actives would work well, as there is lower irritation potential. Let's talk about something that often confuses people, the difference between L-ascorbic acid and tetrahexyldecyl ascorbate. L-ascorbic acid is widely recognized as the gold standard when it comes to vitamin C in skincare. Maybe you've tried it yourself and experienced that uncomfortable stinging or redness, or maybe you've heard it's notoriously unstable, degrading quickly after opening. That's where tetrahexyldecyl ascorbate comes in. It's an oil-soluble form of vitamin C, which allows it to penetrate the skin's lipid barrier more easily. It is also much more stable than L-ascorbic acid and doesn't require a low pH to remain effective. That's a big deal because it is often the low pH, around 3.5, of L-ascorbic acid formulas that irritates sensitive skin, not necessarily the vitamin C itself. Sounds amazing, right? But here's the catch. While early studies show that tetrahexyldecyl ascorbate can convert to active vitamin C within the skin and help with hyperpigmentation and signs of aging, the available data is limited. The sample sizes are small and most studies have some limitations. In contrast, L-ascorbic acid has decades of solid research proving its effectiveness for brightening collagen production and antioxidant protection. My take? I personally prefer L-ascorbic acid because I tolerate it well and appreciate the stronger evidence. But if you struggle with irritation or dislike the idea of using low pH products, tetrahexyldecyl ascorbate is absolutely worth trying. It is a great way to get some of the benefits of vitamin C without the downside of sensitivity. Now, what else is in the formula? The first thing I notice is that squalane is quite high up on the ingredient list, which explains the lotion-like texture. There are also other moisturizing and hydrating components like glycerin, acetamidoethoxyethanol, and sugars. And in fact, I feel like if your skin is oily, this might well work as a last step in your routine in summer without the need for additional moisturizer. Then you have vitamin E as additional antioxidant, and then, kind of counteracting the benefits of their vitamin C choice for sensitive skin, a whole lot of fragrant essential oils from the citrus family, alongside limonene and linalool. Now, obviously, what your skin reacts to will depend on your sensitivities, but fragrant essential oils are common culprits in those that react, which is why I wouldn't wholeheartedly support the recommendation of this product for sensitive skin. The Sunday Riley C.E.O. Serum has a beautiful texture and a lovely scent. It is one of those products that makes your skincare routine feel a little more luxurious. I can absolutely see it being great for those with maturing skin looking for a gentler vitamin C option, or for anyone that struggles with irritation from L-Ascorbic Acid but still wants to enjoy antioxidant benefits, if the price point is within your reach, that is. However, I do recommend patch testing first, especially if you're prone to reactions from fragrant essential oils. And if you enjoyed this video, you will most likely enjoy the ones put on the screen here. Don't forget to check out the description box for everything else I have to offer, and like and subscribe so you don't miss the next video.